He might have left the jungle, but Dermot Brereton has somehow managed to continue to prank Shane Crawford on I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here. As the days go by, the celebrities' tummies continue to grumble, and it was only a matter of time before we said farewell to another celeb. Last night, sadly, it was Tahir's turn to pack his bags and get out of there. But we're lucky enough to chat to him right now. G'day, Tahir.
Hello, oh my God, I'm shocked.
Well, we have to start off by asking about your luxury item, the violin you couldn't play. Mm. Who do you think you annoyed the most?
Thanks, Angela. Well, I think I annoyed probably Justine, Tash, definitely, Richard. Justin was annoyed especially. Evie didn't like it. Angie. I think the only person who loved the violin was Dermot and he left. Luke doesn't mind it, but in that order, probably most of the camp. Doesn't matter, but they don't appreciate good music.
And Tahir, last night the Celebs gave you permission to play your violin. In hindsight, if you could have picked a different item, any different item, would you have changed it and what would have been?
Yeah, I would have probably chosen a piano. That would have been really good. I could have hidden a lot of contraband in there, stuffed everywhere, wouldn't have starved, but that would have been handy. I think another musical instrument that I couldn't play would have been perfect.
Difficult to carry around, though.
Sure. Who would have thought that Australia would think you're the best person to be camp chef? Now, you pulled a bit of a prank on your campmates by pretending to spill dinner on the floor. Who do you think was most upset?
Oh, this is building up for days. I've been tossing the vegetables and flipping them and they got so worried. Oh, my God, we're going to spill a vegetable. We're going to starve. Relax. This is fun. So I got the fake veggies, flipped them everywhere, and, of course, Richard's face was priceless. For the first time, he couldn't talk.
That's a miracle. Everyone looked so emotional to get their letters from home. What did it mean to you to hear from your loved ones?
It was incredible, honestly. It was, it like boosted me, energised me, and it was a huge pickup, and I just loved it. And I've held on to it every single night, read it, looked at the photo, but it was a big night for me, big. Mm.
Early on in the show, you competed against the chapstick king himself, Justin, in the Sunday Slam, and actually won. That must have been quite a victory, given he's the king of trials.
Yeah, yeah. It was a huge victory. Thank you for recognising that. I appreciate it. He's a world record holder, king of trials. I beat him. And I did it without lip balm. No chapstick. chapstick. I had no chapstick. There you go. So, really, I should have his crown, but doesn't matter. He can have it.
And Tahir, did you learn anything about yourself from your time in the jungle, apart from the fact that you can't play the violin?
I did learn a few things. I can survive with hunger. Mm. For much longer than what I thought. And I think portion control is a big lesson for everybody in the jungle. Nobody needs to eat massive amounts of food, and that was a massive lesson. But having said that, I'm going to just smash every food I can get my hands on right now for the next month. That's it. That's maybe longer, forever. Yeah. But there's other lessons. It's just learning new things, like starting a fire was pretty cool to do that. And just sleeping outdoors amongst the animals, it's real. People think it's fake. I can hear them. Mm. Baboons having a fight. It's all real. I'm scared. At night time, I'm very scared. I wasn't going to swear.
Well, apart from eating your body weight in pasta, what are you going to do now that you're out of the jungle?
I'm going straight back into tour. I'm going to tour all the comedy festivals all around Australia and basically back to my passion, stand-up comedy. But I've got to memorise my new show first.
Mm. That's the tricky part. And who would you like to see crowned king or queen of the jungle?
I would love for the king of the crown to be Luke. I would love if he was crowned the king of the jungle. That would be really good. My best buddy in the camp, and that would be awesome.
Yeah, nice.
Lovely to have you on the show this morning. You've been a ball of laughs in the jungle.
Thank you.
So thanks
everybody.
So much for joining us.
Thanks, Tahir.
So, who will be the next celebrity to leave the jungle? Vote for your favourites to keep them safe. And, of course, don't forget to tune in to I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here tonight at 7:30 p.m. on 10 and Win.